In this chapter, we will talk about SQLite Database, the database which helps you storing multiple records, as it might be possible that you are recording high scores or saving chats. I will demonstrate the database operations and perform database queries to create a database, add tables to it, and pre-populate it with the data, all with the help of friendly SQLite helper. So, before we continue this session, I assume that you all are familiar with databases. As in general, SQLite uses standard SQL syntax, structured query language. You're also familiar with SQL databases. This chapter is a quick reference and will refresh all the database concepts you already know. So, what is a SQLite database? It is the relational database which is open source, so you can use it for free. And the main reason for using the database is it is a lightweight database, which is created specially to work with mobile applications. SQLite database stores the structured data in a private database safely. The data gets stored in the table format, which contains several rows and columns, just like we have in an XML spreadsheet. And just like cells in a spreadsheet, database tables has fields. These fields contains the data, or reference to other fields, or to reference to other tables as well. To store a particular type of data, I recommend that your table should have a single integer primary key column called ID. A primary key is designated to the table column to uniquely identify all the table records, because it contains a unique value for each row of the data. When we talk about table structure in the database, it is represented like this, containing the column with names, ID, word, and definition, where ID is for the primary key of the table, and it also has three unique rows. The reason for implementing SQLite database engine are many. It is considered as a standalone or self-contained in the sense that it doesn't require any other dependencies. It runs on any operating system. It is considered as the local database and requires no server backend. The data can be stored in a SQLite database on the file system in a flat files. And Android comes with built-in SQLite embedded in the device, so you don't need to require any extra library or setup procedure to use SQLite with Android applications. It is amazingly stable, which means every change within the database works in the transaction. That will be done either completely or not at all, but doesn't leave it half done. It means if you are updating several pieces of data and something goes wrong, you can roll back the transaction as well. A transaction is a sequence of operations performed as a single logical unit of work. That means the changes must follow the ACID properties. ACID is an acronym, stands for atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. This means every update, insert, and delete operation is ACID. Running database operations inside the transaction ensures that all the changes either occur completely or not at all. So there is no midway of getting a chance for losing data. Even if for any reason an error occurs and the transaction is unable to complete, the system should return to the state before the transaction was started. Error could be any. The program stopped responding, operating system crashed, or power failure, or could be any. Let's understand each of these characteristics of ACID properties one by one. Atomicity property identifies that either the transaction completely full or not at all. Consistency is all about the system state, means if the transaction completes successfully, then all the changes will have been properly made. Isolation will ensure that each transaction is unaware of another transaction, means if there are two concurrent transactions running, their modifications must be isolated from each other. Durability is the state that ensures that once a transaction has been successfully completed, all the changes it has made to the system are permanent. Now, let's see how we can perform database operations by running queries. SQLite provides you four basic SQL operations. These are insert, delete, update, and retrieve. Insert. This operation inserts new data into the database tables. We use insert statement for it. Delete. This operation deletes existing data from the database tables with delete statement. Update. This statement updates existing data into database tables using update statement. And retrieve. This statement retrieves the data from the database tables using select statement. And this is how we write SQL query for select statement. Select word description from word list table, where word is equals to alpha. In generic, select columns from table, where column is equals to some value. In top example, we are selecting word and description column from the table word list table with the condition specifying that only those results will be selected whose word values matches with the alpha. SQLite select statement is used to fetch the data from the database table, which returns data in the form of result table. Select query is written for getting the result in two ways, either by specifying the column names or all columns by using asterisk to be selected from the tables from which to get the results. We also have where mentioned in the query. Where is the keyword used to specify a condition while fetching the data from the table. If the given condition is satisfied, then it returns a specific values from the table. You would use where clause to filter the records and fetching only necessary records. We can specify a condition using comparison or logical operators like equal to, like, less than, or greater than. Like operator is used to match text values against a pattern. If the search expression matches to the pattern expression using some wildcard, the like operator will return the true. The select statement can be expanded to a long query using AND, ORDER BY, or LIMIT. This is how a select query can be written. Before getting into how the query displays the result, let's first understand few clauses which are used in it. Starting with AND OR clause, you can connect to compile multiple conditions using logical operators. And as you can see, we are specifying the condition on two columns using AND operator. We have ORDER BY clause, which is used to sort the data in ascending and descending order based on one or more columns, and in this query we have sort the result in descending order by word column. We use ASC for ascending, DESE for descending. And now we have limit clause to get a limited number of results, and here it will display only one result. So here are some sample select queries. We have select star from word list table to get the whole table. The next one will return only those results where ID is greater than 2. And here are some more queries. And some more. Queries can be created via raw query method. And as you can see from these examples on the screen, raw query directly accepts a SQL select statement as input. It provides a way to provide selection arguments to a SQL query as well. You can pass a string array with a greater than element as you have with a question mark. As seen in this example, argument value 2 will be passed in the query. Queries can be created with a query method also. It provides a structured interface for specifying the SQL query. Here, on the left, the SQL query is written. And on the right, we have implemented the query using query method. It retrieves rows from the database as selected by a SQL query. It constructs a SQL query string and sends it as a raw query to the database. The next we have is cursors and how to use cursors to get the data from the database. Well, a cursors give you an access to the database record sets. You specify what data you want to access to, and the cursors brings back the records from the database. We get the records by writing queries, which always returns a cursor object. You then navigate through the records supplied by the cursor. Or, in simpler words, you can think of it as a pointer to the table rows. You will learn more about cursors in the following chapter on SQLite Database. These are the links for your reference. Go check them out after the session and learn more about SQLite Database, SQLite class, and Cursor class. There is a link on Hands-on SQL link. Also, you can practice your SQL queries there. So, what's next? Just check out this chapter, and thanks for watching.